Hi, this is Rich. Hey, I just wanted to mention something to you guys. It's between me and you and the lamppost. I know I've been going on and on and on about soul contracts and agreements and stuff recently in the last few months. But I just want to let you guys know that it really, really does work. It's just, it's hard to explain and why and how. And I know that I want to learn how to promote it better and market it better, so it's more like it clicks, it's worth giving it a shot. And I want to learn how to teach it better. I want to streamline my training program for it, and I'm researching what you'd call it, the quick and dirty version. Is there another way to learn how to do this like really fast? Because I really want to, I want you guys to have not just the opportunity, but the inspiration to, okay, I'll give it a try. You know, for those of you who haven't, or you've looked into the soul contract thing before, you know, maybe. This shit's fucking amazing. I did a session yesterday on not having enough time and wasting time. And some of the most profound realizations about myself and this. It's like, I first found out about the New World Order, the Illuminati, in 1970. I read a book called None Dare Call It Conspiracy. And I learned about the Trilateral Commission and the Committee on Foreign Relations. That was the two big organizations back then. It might even have been before the Bilderbergers, but the New World Order thing. And even back then, there were these scare stories and the threat of financial collapse and world domination, right? And I was in my spiritual studies back then. And it was like, I felt the need to hurry up and get myself in better shape and do what I could to help save the planet, right? And probably even before that, but I really felt like I don't have enough time. I don't have enough time to do anything except this very urgent stuff, right? So yeah, I was on a spiritual path, man. I was spending all my time, except for the part where I was wasting my fucking time too. I was wasting a lot of time. And the logic at the time was that if I can't do what's important, I'm just going to kill time until I can, or I'm looking for ways to make enough money to pay for the advanced spiritual training that I wanted back in the 70s, right? In the 70s and 80s. Anyway, I didn't know anything about agreements and soul contracts and stuff. So, my life turned into what it became. Philosophy, study, research, stuff like this. And I would never get really much done around the house, you see. I'm like, this doesn't get done, the yard doesn't get mowed, the repairs don't get done on the car or this or that. It's like, because I don't have enough time, man. Leave me alone, man. I'm thinking here. No, not really. I stopped smoking dope, even almost before I got started, back in the 70s. I didn't have time for that shit anymore, man. Got any brownies? Huh? Anyway, wasting my time doing that shit, right? So, it's been a way of life. Now, so yesterday I do this. Finally, it just occurred to me. I was getting so aggravated and annoyed. I was getting distractions all over the place. you know, car repairs, house repairs, money issues, this is one, you know, just all kinds of crap. The latest one is, we're out in California, right? Yeah, we're in California. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, in the country. Yeah. Our well went dry. Yeah, it's a drought. No, really, it is. There really is a drought out here. Well, I don't know about a drought, but there's definitely, everybody's wells are going dry. So our well went dry a long time ago. So we get water shipped in, right? So we got a big tank out there. But there's a leak, some serious freaking leak. It's water to the house, but half the water that comes into the house is leaking underground somewhere. I mean, a lot of water. It's like a hose turned on completely, full blast. And it's going that way while it's coming into the house. Or if it's just, you know, the pressure's loaded up for the house so you can use the faucets and the toilets and showers and everything. You can't use it because there's an underground leak. I don't have time to fix it. I don't have time. So we go out and we turn off the water pump. And I keep the water in the big giant tank until we need to flush a fucking toilet. Yeah, so these are very important things, but I don't have time to do it. Anyway, annoying, that's just one example of the kind of exasperating things that I know. I'd get angry and frustrated. And so the quality of my life changed emotionally on a day-to-day because of an agreement, a deep-seated agreement within me that I don't have enough time for lots of things. And the agreement that I waste time. Now, did I notice that I waste time and then agree to it? Or did I agree to waste time and forget, because I did it before I got here to this world, and then start wasting time because I agreed that I would? And now I waste time, and then I notice it, and I go, yeah, I do waste time. And now I agree to it a second time. Is that how it worked? Is that what happened? Pretty much. So anyway, yesterday I did a session on this stuff, the soul contract revocation thing that I share and teach in my soul contract revocation bootcamp, right? So I had no idea how it would change my life. Or how I am. So I did it. And I rattle off. And I teach you how to do it in the training program. But I got like about 70 agreements that had to do with it. You know, I can do this real fast. I got the worksheet up. Just a minute. I'll just rattle off a few. Oh, I agree that I can't manage my time very well, that I'm the effect of time. I waste my time on bullshit. Then little agreements like, yeah, I waste my time editing my text. Are you kind of anal? You know, it's like typo here. And you, not just the punctuation or the spelling, but, I should word it different. Like right now, I'm wasting my freaking time talking to you about these details. But, another one. Let's see. What else? Just to give you an example of what I'm talking about. I agree that I don't use my time wisely. I agreed. Okay, I revoked these agreements yesterday. I don't have enough time to work around the house. I don't have time to work out. I don't have time to do the dishes. How convenient. Okay? I simply do not have enough time. Right? And it just goes on and on and on and on. And it explains why I can't stand waiting for taxis or buses or planes. It's like our slow internet connections. Because I don't have time for this shit, right? And it's like it's an emotional and stress city and impatient. And oh my God. I'm not always like that, but yeah, pretty much. So I'm going, wow, wow, wow. And so I'm having a good time. Yeah. Listing out all these things about myself, and then I looked through what I'd written up and I spotted what it was that I agreed to and agreed with. And then I did the revocation on it. And it's not like when you end a session, it's not like, wow! Sometimes you have some good realizations and your mind is quiet. But it's not like a lot of release work that I've done over the years where it's like, wow, and you feel good for a little while. and then it fizzles. You know, a couple hours, a couple of days, a couple of weeks, but it fizzles and you're back to. Now, this kind of work, when you revoke these agreements, whatever they happen to be, and you break, you revoke them in clusters. They're all associated with the same issue, right? So you get that out, and you start taking the issue apart. But a lot of your issues are like four or five issues to jam together to make one what you see and perceive as your issue. Like diet issues or overweight issues or relationship issues or something. That's an issue, but that issue has a lot of little smaller issues, and each of the smaller issues have a group, a ton of freaking agreements to it. Now you can call it soul contract agreement or just agreements. It's shit you agree to, and you don't even have to believe in or subscribe to the concept of soul contracts or making agreements with the karmic lords or these entities or any of that. This is really about agreement and what you agree to and what you agree that is and what you agree that exists and what you agree is your reality. And like, there are certain things that piss you off. You would agree that that pisses you off. If you didn't agree that that pissed you off, whatever that was, it wouldn't. It's really weird that way. Anyway, all that said, I revoked all those agreements yesterday. It's like, wow, completely different. All of a sudden, well, I choose not to agree that I don't have enough time anymore, and I choose to not agree. Did I say that right? I choose to not agree that I don't have enough time. I have plenty of time. I have time to do it all. I can do it all. Okay, and I was agreeing that I waste my time. And I don't agree. No, I don't. No. It doesn't matter what I'm doing. I'm not wasting my time doing it. And you know what? It's no longer a self-fulfilling prophecy in belief or chatter in your head. Oh, I'm just wasting my time. I shouldn't do that. You know, and you regain, you bury it, and you try not to think about it. But you know, I know I'm wasting my fucking time doing this shit. What am I fucking doing? I'm not getting my job. I'm not getting, right? All that agreement crap. Done. I don't know. No more negativity. If this revoking these agreements will help you stop with your negative thinking too, because you just don't agree. Yeah, no. You have the conscious ability to no longer agree to certain things. So anyway, yesterday and today too. Yesterday I did all kinds of shit around the house. I have an RV with a slider that is stuck, and you tear shit apart, and buzz saws, literally, get the big dually truck out in the back and wrap a big rope around the slider and to fold the slider. I mean, it was a big job. It was sitting there for a year not getting done because I didn't have time to fuck with that shit. And then there's some leaks in the trailer and the carpets. We just had a big rain here in dried up California. Yay, it's raining. Oh, shit. Yeah, leaky trailer. So, carpet's all wet. I had to pull the carpet out, but I never had time for that shit. Did yesterday. Sure did. Had time for that. And time to do loads of clothes. I never had time to wash freaking clothes. Are you kidding me, man? I ain't got no time. Got any brownies? Anybody? Because that's clothes washing thing. You got it. I ain't doing that shit. I ain't got time for that crap. Oh, hi. How you doing? I'm kidding. I'm kidding. I can talk like a Mexican too, but I'm not Mexican. I can talk like a... Never mind. Moving right along, I do have time to crack a joke or two, or a wisecrack or two. Hope it's funny. Okay. So yeah, two loads of clothes, and drying too, and hung up the good shit. You know, that'll wrinkle if you don't get it out of the dryer. I even have time for that. Who has time for that? Oops, forgot that. Oh no, I had time. A lot of time, and videos too. I made some videos as well. It's amazing. Yeah, and worked out. I had time to work out. push-ups, squats. The point, this stuff really, really does work. You know, there's some little things about it that you need to know, and it can get creepy. As you get better, your shit hits you in the face like, ugh, is this better? I don't know if I like better. Yeah, it's better. It's like ignorance is bliss, right? You know, you stop being ignorant and you start looking at what's going on in the world and you go, oh, this is fucked up. Ugh. And do you stick your head back in the sand? Do you wish you never knew? Or do you go, ugh, this is fucked up. Ugh, damn. And you're glad you, on some level, you're glad you do know what's going on. Or do you prefer to be like somebody down the street who's like, doesn't know, doesn't want to know, doesn't care? So yeah, there's some things to know about this old contract stuff and agreement stuff. It really, really works. And I encourage you to give it a shot. In my course, it's like, you know, there's a 30-day absolute money-back guarantee, no questions asked. You can do the whole freaking course, get a lot out of it or nothing, and say, Rich, can I have my money back? I need a refund. It doesn't matter why. Yeah. After 30 days, it's a little different. We won't get into that. 6 months down the road. Hey, Rich, I'm out of money. Can I have $89? You said. I didn't say that. Okay. Now, let me get embarrassed a little bit if I'm talking about money. I haven't got all my money issues sorted out yet. Still working on it. Okay. But the point is, one last time, is that this stuff really, really does work. And I want to learn how to present it better, promote it better, market it better, share it with you better, to inspire you to give it a go. Just give it a shot, see how it works for you. And if it doesn't work, you know, it's okay. But it should work. I mean, it does work. It works so well. It just amazes me how well it works. This is after 40 years of looking and trying out and doing all kinds of clearing techniques and emotional release techniques and limiting beliefs and all kinds of stuff, right, for betterment. This is the best I've come up with so far. And you know, there's probably going to be more great stuff, better, as I learn about more great stuff. But yeah, this works. So, and I also want to learn to teach it more, better, in a more concise approach. Right now I've got what I've got and it's working, but I sense that for some people it's too long. It's taken a little too long. Rich, is there a way you can sort of condense this? And I'm working on that. It's not up yet. But you can go on the website and you can see on the side there, richwest.net, and on the side you'll see these blue links, and it says lesson 1, 2, 3, 4, like that, and you see how many lessons there are. And you do that, and that's the course, and you will learn how to do this. Okay. So anyway, yeah, I just want to make this quick video, and this is for me, this is quick, you know, under 20 minutes, that's a short video for me. Anyway, I have time for long ones, you see. Anyway, hey, thank you for watching and subscribing. Hey, I'm almost to 2 million views. And I got to do something fancy when I hit 2 million views. And lastly, I've done a couple of radio interviews on Outer Limits Radio and on ND5 Radio with Michelle Walling. And Outer Limits was with Ryan McCormick. Ooh, I spelled his name. I said Brian. Is it Brian or Ryan? I think it's Ryan. Mr. McCormick. Okay, I'll fix that in a sec. But yeah, I'm doing these. And I got another radio interviewing view coming up on BBS Radio with Magdalena Winkler. So I'm going, whoa, this is cool. I had fun with the first two. So, I'm just saying, if you'd like to listen to me on one of your favorite internet radio or shows as a host. I mean, as a guest interviewee and all that. Yeah, write your show. Write to him. Write to him and say, hey, I know this guy. You got to hear this guy, man. He talks about wild and crazy shit, man. And yeah, and so I'm open to more interviews. So anyway, also, if you know of some radio shows that I don't know about, I haven't really looked into it yet and contacted a lot of radio shows or anything like that. But I have thought about, this would be kind of fun to do some more radio interviews. So if you know of any, you can write to them or you can write to me in a comment or email and say, yeah, hey, check these guys out. I like these. I watch these guys all the time. All right. Well, thank you for watching. And I will talk to you all later. Go over to richwest.net and check out my Soul Contract Relocation Bootcamp, if you are so inclined. Stuff really works amazingly. It really does. Okay, that's all. Said that. Okay. Gotta go. You know, I love talking to you guys. I really do. This is my thing, man. I like to do this. So, anyway, that's why it's like, are you done yet? No. We'll talk some more, but I better go. All right. You guys take care. Thanks for watching. Thanks for the things you do, subscribing and sharing your kind and supportive comments and sharing your philosophy and thoughts on the various videos that I do. Okay. See you later. Who's that? That's new. Just kidding around. What? Okay. Take care now.